I want to show you guys how to steal the basic color grade of this frame from this movie. I picked this clip right here because it has that similar desert vibe like the Dune movie. I don't want to copy this look on a very colorful clip like this or like this because it doesn't make sense. So I guess that's my first tip. The look has to make sense for the context of your clip first before you try to copy the look. Oh, that makes sense. Now, a lot goes into color grading these high-end movies, and I'm not a professional colorist, but I've seen how it's done, and it's hours and hours of work. That's why I said in the beginning, we're only gonna copy and match the basic feel or the basic grade of this frame. So we're gonna keep it simple. That's what we're doing on this channel anyway. We're gonna match the tones first, and then we're gonna match the colors. The two clips are on the timeline, so let's change the workspace so that we can have a side-by-side comparison view. Go to your color grading workspace, and if you don't have one yet, I'll leave a video in the description on how I did mine. Or you can also just go to workspace and choose color and effects for now. The reason why we do this is because we want as much space as possible to see as much information as we can. So go to Window, Go To, and Comparison Viewer. We want to see the scopes of both clips, so click on View here and Video Scopes. We can do the same with the other clip, and I suggest using the one square frame and a vertical layout so that you can nicely see the waveforms close to each other. For the tones, because that's the first thing we're going to look at today, I like to use the Luma waveform. And looking at these guys, we can already tell that there's a lot of warm yellow in the frame from Dune, but we're going to address that later. Right now, we're just going to look at the tones without worrying about the colors. Look at this waveform. Everything sits nicely under 75 IRE and above 0 IRE, so the information in the highlights and the shadows are preserved and the mid-tones are somewhat compressed. We can see that here too. No blown-out highlights, soft shadows, very cinematic, if you like that word. By the way, if you are a beginner, from the bottom up, you can see the darker tones to the highlights and horizontally represent what you see on the clip from left to right. So this right here on our clip are all brighter tones, mid-tones and highlights, and really no shadows at all, this part right here. Notice that these shots are different because one is out in the open and the other one is in a covered area. It's like a cave. But I still want to create a contrast between the highlights and the mid-tones in our clip. So let's use a curves adjustment. And I want to use the color picker to select the brighter tones on our face and bring it down a little bit. Maybe bring down the darker tones as well. But of course, we still have to keep the shadows above 0 IRE to match the frame we want to copy. Actually, let's move this to the mid-tones and bring this back up to create that contrast, like on the face of Zendaya here. I like it. I like it. Of course, you can always slightly adjust and refine this curve to your liking, but the idea is to replicate the contrast. So if you pull up the highlights, you gotta pull down the mid-tones a little bit. You can also do the same thing with color wheels. I just think it's easier to select specific points with the curves. Or maybe I just prefer working with curves. Okay, let's work on the colors now. And I'm gonna change the waveform to an RGB overlay for both. And quick moment of vulnerability, I've always been intimidated by this waveform right here. But this is how you read it. You can tell here that there is more red in the highlights and green in the mid-tones and mostly balanced in the shadows because it's mostly white with a little tint of blue. Now, when we look at our hero shot, it's actually not that bad. It doesn't look like we will have to do a lot to match the look we want. And that's why it's important to copy a look that makes sense with your clip. But I still want to take some of these blues away from the shadows, so let's open a new color wheels adjustment and move this to the yellows to negate the blues. Basically, you just go the opposite way from the blues. And now it looks warmer, but it looks too orange for me. Remember, the mid-tones had some greens, so let's add some greens in the mid-tones. And lastly, we're gonna add reds in the highlights to balance it out a little bit, just like in the highlights of the Dune frame. It looks pretty good. Let me show you guys the RGB parade waveform to see the difference here. Look at how they brought that blue down, and we kind of did that, but because of the difference between the two locations, we have this high up here. And to be honest, I'm happy with what we did so far, but you can also use the color curves adjustment to adjust the colors, and I'm probably gonna do another video just on curves adjustments, because there are a lot of things that you can do with the curves. But let me show you a couple of things that I did to kind of refine the look even more. I used the hue versus sat in the hue saturation curves to desaturate the colors except for the reds and the oranges. And I always recommend removing the saturation from the brightest highlights and the darkest shadows to try to keep them pure black and pure white. Let's disable all the effects. And here is our final look. Before and after. Not bad. What you guys think? With no plugin. It looks like it's taken from the same clip, right? From the same movie, at least the same tone, the same vibe. And like I said in the beginning, guys, it takes more than these limited tools in Final Cut Pro to color grade these high-end movies, but we were able to go through the thought process of how to dissect these frames so that we can actually copy, you know, the basic form or the basic grade of the look. But that's what we have for today, guys. That's it. If you got any value from this one, subscribe and check out these videos about color correcting and color grading, and I will see you guys in the next one. Hopefully. Peace.